So neurotoxicity is basically the manifestations that patients experience, usually with the cytokine release syndrome. It usually occurs at the same time or shortly after. And the way to think about it is like a delirium. I think people might be more familiar with delirium. And probably what is happening is that the inflammation generated by the CAR T therapy as it attacks the tumor is affecting the nervous system. I mean, that's probably the simplest way to think about it. There's a spectrum of severity in neurotoxicity, all the way from sort of difficulties with attention, difficulties carrying on a conversation, difficulties expressing, you know, patient could have difficulty expressing themselves, all the way in severe cases that have been reported, but thankfully we have not experienced, of coma and cerebral edema, which in its most serious manifestation could be life-threatening. So as far as what a patient would experience with neurotoxicity, the way that I've had patients describe it to me is almost like being in a foreign country and not speaking the language, so sort of that kind of disorientation. And what their loved ones might notice is that they have a harder time communicating, and they have a harder time doing things that normally would come easily, for instance, getting up, going to the restroom, writing a sentence, attention, difficulties with attention. And that's what the clinicians and the nurses look for, and that's often what family members will see as well. One other thing I should mention, a more concerning thing that we look for and what we're actually most worried about is when somebody becomes sleepy and they have a hard time waking up. And that's a more concerning finding. But the other findings are sort of common, actually. I mean, in some sense expected. So the way that we treat neurotoxicity in the setting of CAR T therapy is, one, we try to reduce systemic inflammation. We have a drug that's specifically targeting an interleukin that reduces inflammation. So that's one of the first things that we'll try. And then in tandem with that, we evaluate potential other causes for confusion. Because while there can be the neurotoxicity, confusion, delirium associated with CAR T therapy, there are also other causes that can mimic that. And so we have to do an evaluation to prove indeed that's what's going on. But if that's our conclusion, we use the drug to reduce systemic inflammation as well as steroids. And again, in extreme cases, we would proceed all the way to potential surgical interventions if needed. We have a dedicated team of neurointensivists that would help guide that path of management should it arise. One other thing that I think folks should know is that we are concerned about neurotoxicity, and so we plan for it. And part of that is that you would meet with myself or one of my colleagues, a neurologist, to perform basically a baseline neurologic evaluation so that we understand exactly who you are and exactly what your neurologic function is. And that's part of our protocol and our standard of care for folks undergoing this therapy. I think just in general, other institutions will have similar therapies, will have the same drugs we have, but the strength of Mayo Clinic is the way that we deliver care.